Dear listeners, tonight I invite you to step into an enchanted world where courage and forgiveness unveil hidden mysteries and unmatched adventures. Sit comfortably, close your eyes, and let the story take you to a magical kingdom where darkness is dispelled by the light of truth and noble sacrifices bring freedom and peace. The Royal Plot. In times long past, when emperors ruled with an iron fist over shining kingdoms, and thieves moved like shadows in the night, there lived a young woman of rare skill named Lyra. Raised in the dark alleys of a large city where poverty and need reigned supreme, Lyra had made a name for herself as the most skillful thief in the kingdom. But fate had bigger plans for her, plans that would take her far from the streets she knew, into the heart of a plot that threatened to change the fate of the kingdom forever. On a clear night, under the starry sky, Lyra carefully pulled her hood over her head, hiding her delicate features. Her ebony black hair and hazel eyes blended into the night's shadows. She was known for her remarkable abilities and her knack for disappearing without a trace. Raised in the harsh alleys, she had learned to steal from a young age, adapting to a life full of dangers. Now, however, she faced the greatest challenge of her life, infiltrating the royal palace. The plan was simple, but dangerous. Dressed in the humble clothes of a maid, Lyra was to sneak into the palace, blend in with the servants, and at the right moment, steal the queen's jewels, objects of immense value. She had to leave no trace, no suspicion. Her crew was counting on her, and failure was not an option. Swallowing her conflicting emotions, Lyra assumed the role of a maid. That night, as she passed through the palace's massive gate, she felt her heart tighten. The palace, an imposing structure of white stone, gleamed under the lantern lights, and the air was filled with floral scents. Every step she took brought her closer to the queen's jewels and a tremendous danger. As soon as she entered, she blended in with the other maids, trying not to draw attention. She observed how each person knew their place and responsibilities well. Wasting no time, Lyra began to learn the court's routine. She closely observed how the servants moved through the palace's vast rooms, how they carried trays with grace, and how they responded respectfully to every command. With each passing day, Lyra adapted more and more to court life. Every gesture, every movement was studied and reproduced exactly, ensuring that no one could distinguish her from the other servants. Quickly learning the daily habits and rituals, she found herself fascinated by the world she was discovering. The palace was a place of contradictions. The splendor and luxury on the surface hid tensions and secrets. And although the people seemed to live in harmony, they had their own agendas and hidden motives. The biggest surprise for Lyra was the queen herself. Although she initially had no opinion about the monarch, observing her from a distance, Lyra began to feel a slight admiration for her. The queen was not just a decorative figure, but a person respected and loved by everyone around her. The servants spoke respectfully about her generosity and kindness, and the people saw her a as a just leader. These details, which Lyra gathered like pieces of a puzzle, began to paint a complex and fascinating picture of the queen. As the days passed, Lyra couldn't help but be impressed by how the queen interacted with people. She saw them bow before her, not out of fear, but out of genuine respect. The queen, in turn, responded with a warm smile, and her gaze was full of understanding and compassion. These small, sincere gestures began to plant the seeds of doubt in Lyra's heart. It was a new and unexpected feeling for her to admire someone she was supposed to see only as a target. Every time she passed by the queen's chamber on her way to the servants' quarters, Lyra felt a pang of guilt. The thought of stealing from someone so respected and kind unsettled her. But she remembered her responsibility to her crew, to the people who raised and shaped her, and the promise she had made. She repeated to herself that this was just another mission, and that she had to stay focused. Nevertheless, in a corner of her heart, she began to question whether her mission was truly just. The admiration she felt for the queen, though faint, grew with each passing day. She wanted to understand more about this strong woman, how she managed to lead her people and earn the respect of those around her. The questions began to accumulate, and the mission seemed increasingly complicated. Lyra didn't know it then, but this small admiration she felt for the queen would play a crucial role in the decisions she would make. In a world full of shadows and secrets, the young thief was beginning to discover not only the palace's secrets, but also her own conscience. Though not yet sure why she felt something in her was changing, perhaps the queen's understanding and compassion were beginning to influence her. Or maybe she was starting to find her own code of honor. But one thing was clear. The mission in the royal palace would not only be about the queen's jewels, but also about discovering the truth and her own identity. On a quiet night, when the full moon cast its silver light over the royal palace, Lyra moved gracefully through the dark corridors, performing her usual exploration routine. She knew her route by heart, each step calculated, each shadow expertly used for concealment. Although she diligently fulfilled her role as a maid, her thief's instincts urged her to explore every corner of the palace, to know every secret door, every hidden window. This desire for knowledge, combined with the need to find the safest path to the queen's jewels, had taken her through these silent corridors countless times. That night, however, something unexpected happened. As she approached a partially open door, she heard whispered but intense voices coming from inside the room. Lyra pressed herself against the wall, trying to become one with the shadow. It was a skill she had mastered perfectly, trained over the years to become invisible when needed. Holding her breath, she leaned closer to hear better. Inside, two high-ranking nobles were having a heated discussion. They talked about an elaborate plan to assassinate the queen, a conspiracy that seemed to involve several influential figures at court. Their voices were full of contempt and determination, and their words painted a clear picture of their dark intentions. Lyra felt her heart pound. It was no longer just a rumor or suspected betrayal, but a real plot. One that could change the kingdom's course. For a moment, she felt a wave of panic and confusion. What was she supposed to do? Her thief's instinct told her to run, to continue her mission, and forget everything she had heard. But another voice, deeper and harder to ignore, whispered that she had to do something. She couldn't remain indifferent to such a threat. Lyra found herself caught between two worlds, one of loyalty to her crew, and another of a burgeoning sense of justice in her heart. Her loyalty to her crew was deep and personal. These were the people who had raised her, who had given her purpose in a cruel and unforgiving world. Although the life of a thief was full of risks, it was the only one she had ever known. But now, uncovering the plot, she began to doubt the morality of her actions. It was becoming increasingly clear that she couldn't carry out her mission without doing something about the plot. Lyra remembered the queen she had silently admired. A strong woman, loved and respected by the people and those at court. The thought that someone might harm her to seize power filled her with indignation. That night, hiding in the shadows, Lyra felt the weight of truth and responsibility for the first time. As the voices in the room continued to discuss the details of their plan, Lyra realized the gravity of the situation. Any mistake on her part could cost the queen's life and the kingdom's stability. This realization overwhelmed her, but also motivated her. Deep down, she knew she couldn't ignore what she had learned. But what could she do? She was just a simple maid, a disguised thief. She wasn't even sure she would be believed if she told the truth. Emerging from the shadows, she remembered all the skills she had, all the tricks she had learned. She needed a plan, one that would expose the plot without raising suspicion about herself. She knew she had to stay calm and act carefully. It was a delicate task, but Lyra was determined to see it through. As she made her way back to the servants' quarters, Lyra felt that something inside her had changed. In a world full of shadows and secrets, she had discovered that she had the power to make a difference. That night, within the palace's silent walls, Lyra became not just a witness to the plot, but a woman who had to choose between her past and a new path. One full of uncertainties, but also promises. And for the first time, Lyra began to wonder if her true loyalty shouldn't be to something greater than herself. Time was running out mercilessly, and each tick of the clock increased the pressure on Lyra. Aware of the gravity of the situation and the impending confrontation, she felt adrenaline coursing through her veins. In a final effort to save the queen and stop the plot, Lyra devised a bold and risky plan based on the limited resources available. Every step was crucial and had to be executed with precision. The first step of the plan was to gather incriminating evidence. Lyra began sneaking into the offices and rooms of the suspected nobles, searching for documents, letters, or any other proof that would confirm their sinister intentions. During one of these nighttime incursions, she was nearly caught by one of the conspirators, but quickly hid in a dark niche, waiting for the danger to pass. She breathed a sigh of relief, only when the footsteps faded away. But this incident made her realize how dangerous the situation was. On another occasion, she discovered a secret room filled with maps and plans, a place apparently used for plotting the attack. She quickly made copies of the documents using a technique she had learned from her mentors. In another night, Lyra discovered a coded letter detailing the assassination plan, which was to take place during the royal ball. The letter was the key she needed, but it had to be deciphered quickly. With the help of an ally among the servants, a smart young man with a passion for cryptography, they managed to decrypt the message. It confirmed the plot and specified the exact time and place of the attack. Realizing she couldn't act alone, Lyra began to seek allies. She remembered a few servants and guards she had observed over time, people loyal to the queen and whom she could trust. With a pounding heart, Lyra approached these people in confidence, revealing the truth about the plot. She knew the risk was enormous. A single mistake or betrayal could destroy everything. One evening, while talking with one of the guards, she noticed a shadow moving on the wall. Lyra and the guard quickly retreated into a side room, hiding until the danger passed. Despite these close calls, many of those she approached were willing to listen and ultimately help her. The plan began to take shape. Lyra's allies devised a detailed plan to thwart the plot. The loyal guards were to be strategically positioned in the throne room and adjacent corridors to observe any suspicious movements and intervene quickly if necessary. The faithful servants were to monitor the activities of the involved nobles, ensuring they had no opportunity to act. During these preparations, Lyra and her allies had to avoid unexpected traps. One evening, while trying to deliver a crucial message to one of the loyal guards, she was intercepted by a suspicious noble. With calculated calm, Lyra pretended she was lost and looking for the exit, managing to fool him and escape unharmed. On another occasion, a group of loyal servants was almost exposed when one of the conspirators started asking uncomfortable questions about their presence in certain parts of the palace. With quick thinking, they convinced him they were there for ball preparations, thus avoiding dangerous exposure. In another attempt to test the loyalty of the servants, the conspirators organized an unexpected inspection of the palace kitchen, where Lyra and her allies planned to meet. Anticipating such a move, Lyra had hidden the incriminating documents in a safe place. Additionally, she orchestrated a brief interruption of the light, caused by a draft that suddenly extinguished the candles, illuminating the corridor and kitchen. In the ensuing darkness, the servants managed to disperse without drawing attention, and the inspectors found nothing compromising. With all these preparations underway, Lyra and her allies worked tirelessly, perfecting every detail of the plan. They established coded signals for quick and efficient communication in emergencies and rehearsed various scenarios, ensuring that every participant knew exactly what to do in any situation. The tension was palpable, but their determination to protect the queen and thwart the plot was equally strong. On the day of the ball, the palace was abuzz with excitement and frantic preparations. Lyra and her allies took their strategic positions, each playing their part meticulously. Lyra, disguised in an elegant gown, mingled with the guests, watching every detail closely. The loyal guards were at their posts, and the servants patrolled discreetly, ready to act at the slightest sign of danger. The night of the grand royal ball had arrived, and the conspiracy against the queen was about to be executed. Lyra, along with her allies, was prepared for the most dangerous night of their lives. With the gathered evidence and a well-laid plan, they had a chance to thwart the plot and save the kingdom. Hidden in the shadows of massive columns, Lyra held her breath. Every moment seemed to stretch into eternity, and her heartbeat matched the slow ticking of a nearby clock. She felt her muscles tense, ready to act at the first sign of danger. Beside her, a few of the loyal guards she had enlisted stood in position, prepared to intervene. Each of them knew what to do. The signals were set, and everyone was on high alert. When the massive doors of the throne room opened, Lyra felt the tension reach a new peak. The conspirators, dressed in gala attire, but carrying dark intentions in their hearts, stepped inside, their faces masked with respectability. The queen, unaware of the truth that was about to be revealed, welcomed them with her characteristic smile, suspecting nothing of the lurking danger. As the ball progressed, Lyra kept her eyes fixed on the conspirators. At one point, one of them approached the queen, offering her a glass of wine. Lyra recognized the vial of poison she had seen during a previous incursion. With a quick and discreet gesture, she signaled the guards. In a moment of terrifying silence, Lyra gave the signal. The loyal guards quickly intervened, surrounding the traitors before they could act. A brief but intense fight ensued in the throne room. Lyra, armed with a small sword hidden in her dress, joined the fray. The confrontation was chaotic. The sound of metal clashing against metal, the shouts, and the noise of the frightened crowd blended into a dizzying cacophony. Lyra moved with agility and grace, dodging attacks and striking back with astonishing precision. At one point, one of the conspirators managed to break free from the circle of guards and rushed toward the queen. But Lyra intervened swiftly, preventing him from reaching his target. With a bold move, she disarmed and immobilized him. In the chaos, each of Lyra's allies acted according to the plan, ensuring no traitor escaped unscathed. When finally silence returned, traitors were captured, bound, and helpless. The queen, shocked and still puzzled by what had happened, looked around at the familiar faces of people she had trusted. With calm determination, Lyra approached the throne, kneeling before the queen, and revealing the plot that had been woven right under her nose. She showed documents and incriminating letters, explaining the assassination plan in detail. In those moments of loaded silence, the queen listened carefully to Lyra's revelations. The truth was hard to accept, but the evidence presented was undeniable. With tears in her eyes, the queen expressed her gratitude to Lyra and her allies, realizing that her life and the kingdom's stability had been saved by these brave servants. She thanked Lyra for her courage and for the difficult choice of revealing the truth, even at the risk of betraying her own crew. After the traitors were escorted out and calm was restored, the queen turned to Lyra, still kneeling. In a gentle voice, the queen offered her pardon for any past transgressions. Moreover, seeing Lyra's potential and courage, she offered her a new life, away from crime and the lawlessness of her past. The queen offered her a unique position as a secret agent of the crown, a chance to use her skills not for theft, but for the kingdom's protection. Lyra, with tears in her eyes and a heart full of gratitude, accepted the queen's offer. She felt it finally found her place in the world, a vocation that allowed her to use her talents for a noble cause. She realized that she was not only changing her life, but also becoming part of something greater than herself, a protector of peace and justice in the kingdom. On the palace terrace, under the dark sky, Lyra watched the sunset. In that blessed silence, Lyra felt that she had found her true calling. Looking at the starry sky, she vowed to dedicate her life to protecting the queen and the kingdom, to be a force for good in a world often dark and full of uncertainties. Through her courage, Lyra demonstrated that anyone, regardless of their past, can choose to be a force for good. Faced with trials and moral dilemmas, she found the strength to do what is right, becoming a beacon of hope and justice for all those around her. And so, her story inspires us to find our own inner light and let it shine, even in the darkest times. And so, dear listeners, we have reached the end of this captivating journey with Lyra, a brave young woman who found her calling. Remember that in every darkness lies a fascinating story, and every shadow can hide a magic waiting to be discovered. If you enjoyed this adventure full of courage and mystery, don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell so you won't miss any other magical stories. The question is, what would you do if you had the chance to become a defender of the kingdom, like Lyra? Would you embrace courage to protect what is right and noble? Or would you stay in the shadows, avoiding dangers? Share your thoughts in the comments. Until next time, have pleasant dreams and magical adventures every night.